Today's article from The Hindu is with respect to India and Nepal relations. In fact, it is with respect to India, Nepal and China equation, how it is going on. And so they are basically focusing on the Nepalese Prime Minister's recent visit to China, and what outcomes it had and what implications it can have on India. Fine. So let's see. First thing that should be clear for that in 2015, we know that there was an earthquake in Nepal in 2015, and at that time there was an unofficial blockade from Indian side, and because of that blockade, I mean, Nepal was at that moment trying to recover from the repercussions that caused because of the earthquake. So at that time, obviously, there was shortage of food, fuel and everything. So that blockade from Indian side, on the border, it not only choked imports of petroleum, but important medicines and earthquake relief material as well. And this all happened in 2015. And from there, the nationalist sentiments within the Nepalese people, especially the youth, it was in the direction which was basically anti-India, because they considered that India imposed blockade at the borders because we didn't heed to its demand with respect to the constitution and with respect to the rights of the Madhesis for which India was asserting. Although the blockade, it was unofficial from Indian side, and India, it passed a statement that it was unofficial and it was because of the security reasons that was not in the hands of Indian government. So this is all this thing. And in 2016, so soon after the blockade was there, Nepalese people, they faced problem with respect to fuel and food, medicines and all these things. So the Nepalese Prime Minister, Mr. Oli, he went to China and asked for relief and signed certain agreements as well. And now also, when he was elected this time as the Nepalese Prime Minister, the first trip he had, the first visit he made, it was to China. So we can see the kind of relationship and the kind of, friction and resistance that is basically coming in India and Nepal relationship. Okay, and obviously China is a very important stakeholder here. Fine. So let's see what the article is saying. It is saying China 2.2. 2.0 second version. That means Mr. Oli had made his visit as Prime Minister to China in March 2016, and at the time Nepal was recovering from the Indian blockade that has paralyzed lives. So the thing is that anti-India sentiments was there in the Nepalese people, and Nepalese nationalism was basically, if one has to say, the Nepalese nationalism is equal to anti-India at that moment. But this is not a new thing. When Nepalese ministers, they have used anti-India sentiments, as a tool for their populist measures. See, one thing should be clear with respect to India and its neighbors, that India has always been, India is a very big country. We have this Indian subcontinent on the name of India only. The entire Indian neighboring countries, they are considered a part of Indian subcontinent. We have Indian Ocean on the name of India. So we can see the kind of stature India is having in this region. So definitely there is a kind of insecurity in the minds of small nations like Nepal, Sri Lanka, Bangladesh with respect to India. There's a term known as Big Brother Syndrome, which is basically with respect to India, and these small nations in Indian neighborhood, they consider India that it is very assertive and it acts like a big brother. It doesn't give them an equal platform and equal footage, right? So this is their insecurities with respect to India. So this is the thing, and this is not new basically. So because of this insecurity, first thing is that these nations, not only Nepal but all these nations, be it Bangladesh or be it Sri Lanka, fine, not these nations not only face insecurity with respect to India, but they also use this anti-India sentiments, fine, to gain some sort of stage or platform with respect to the populist measures. I mean, they try to portray themselves as nationalist, fine, because if they are fighting against India, they try to portray themselves as nationalist and showing India as a nation which is basically working against their own interest. So in this manner, so this is not a new thing that the ministers in Nepal are using. It dates back to the time of Shah kings and Rana rulers as well. Fine, so this is not a new phenomena that India is witnessing with respect to Nepal. Now, I have already told you that what all happened in 2015 at the time of blockade, fine, and at the time of earthquake, and soon after that, blockade was there, fine. So, and okay, so this I have already told, and because of that blockade, what happened? An entire generation of young Nepalese who were already, alienated from India because of newer education destinations. See, earlier India was the sole education destination for them, but now because of the emergence of new education destinations, these Nepali youth, they are some sort of alienated from India, and because of that blockade, they were entirely against India, fine, and they saw this blockade as a move against a neighbor which had not got its act right, fine. So this is the thing, fine. Now see, this is these are very good lines, although I mean this whole article or editorial is, it is with respect to Nepalese point of view, fine. Because if some Indian writer would have written this, then the perspective would have been different. But we have to extract out the information which we can use in our answers and essays with respect to India and Nepal relationship. So he's saying that Nepal has historically remained India locked, rather being termed landlocked. See, Nepal is a country which is basically landlocked. On one side it is having China, on another side it is having India. Fine. So the issue with Nepal is that it is not having that sort of proper connectivity with China because of the terrain problem. Fine. The terrain is so rough and so hard along Nepal-China border. But with India, Nepal is having an open border right from 1950. We have a friendship treaty with the Nepal, and since then we are having an open border where both means Nepalese and Indian people, they can come and go, fine. And interesting thing is that Nepalese people, they don't have to show any sort of certificate, any sort of I mean certificate or any sort of thing in India to come and go. But yeah, I can say as a goodwill gesture or something, recently government has done that Indian people, they have to basically show something in Nepal. I'm not very sure about it, but they have to show something in Nepal while they're traveling to it. Fine, so this is the thing. So anyway, Nepal has always considered itself not as a landlocked country but as an India-locked country, because whatever trade and transit Nepal is having with other countries in South Asia, or I mean in different countries, with different countries, Nepal is doing it via India. Fine, Nepal is using Indian ports as well for its exports and imports, all these things, fine. So that's why India is a kind of more bigger for Nepal. Nepal don't consider itself as landlocked, instead India locked, fine. So this is the level of insecurity in Nepal. Okay, now being landlocked is not much of an issue as one can get sea locked like Maldives, but to be com because Nepal is completely dependent on India, fine, and to be completely dependent on a single country, fine, for transit rights. That is the issue, and that is the issue with Nepal, fine. Although in 2016, when Mr. Oli he visited China for the first time, he had certain sort of trade and transit agreement with China. Fine, and fine. So this trip, which was made in 2 years ago, recently also Mr. Oli he had a visit to China, and he tried to consolidate all those agreements. Fine. Now, because we know that USA is trying to, it's the line is USA receding to its own cocoon, means USA is trying to retreat itself and concentrate itself to America only. Fine, it is not trying to involve in different kind of issues, and we have already discussed that how Trump is trying to follow unconventional methods which its predecessors have not done. Fine, so USA is retreating, right? So obviously the center stage of the world politics is going to be held by China right now. Okay, so China became the enabler of connectivity, world trade, dependency, and we also know that because of this Belt and Road Initiative, China has basically become a country which can provide you connectivity, which can provide you opportunities for world trade, finance and infrastructure development and all these things. So the thing is that this Chinese Belt and Road Initiative, it is all already accepted by countries like Pakistan, Sri Lanka and Maldives. Fine. And we know that India is opting out from this Belt and Road Initiative. India has not accepted this Belt and Road Initiative because of the involvement of that CPAC, fine, China-Pakistan Economic Corridor, which lies in our Gilgit-Baltistan region. And India says that because China is passing that CPAC through that region, which officially belongs to India, so it is definitely a hit on India's sovereignty. So that's why India is opting out from this Belt and Road Initiative. Now what is left for China? Because China really want India to be a part of this Belt and Road Initiative, and China knows that Nepal and India they are having open borders. So definitely in South Asia, the left country is Nepal. If China is able to have a very, you know, clear and very smooth trade and transit and connectivity with the Nepal, then Chinese goods, they can be supplied to India via this open border through Nepal and China. Fine. So see, the China is very clever, and Nepali Prime Minister Mr. Oli also knows this thing. Fine, he understands this, and that's why he is using this Chinese card against India, basically. Fine, so therefore Nepal will be connected with China through a railway network in addition to roads. See, China is building railway networks to connect to Nepal. China is building roads, optical fiber cables has already been there. Then apart from that, China, there are certain agreements on the basis of that China, Nepal can also sell its surplus power supply, fine, to China as well. So Nepal's dependency on India, fine, it would be certainly reduced. So this is the thing. Now, for Nepal, this nurturing the relationship with China, see, for Nepal, maintaining a relationship with China is not a matter of choice. I mean, okay, it's rather a compulsion, because Nepal has seen the kind of blockade in 2015 and how much the people of Nepal, they have suffered from that blockade. Okay, so that's why Nepal don't want that kind of situation in future. So Nepal don't want to depend on all along a single country. It wants to have, you know, certain alternatives. So obviously relationship and nurturing this relationship with China is a kind of compulsion for Nepal. Fine. Apart from that, so now we know that because this relationship of Nepal and China is a result of compulsion, not a matter of choice. So definitely the onus lies on India to rethink a long-term basis that how to recalibrate and how to redefine its relationship with Nepal. Because we know that after the 2015 blockade, India and Nepal are not having that good relationship because of Chinese presence, definitely. So definitely the onus lies on India's shoulders now. Fine. And Nepal is a place of opportunity for people from border towns of India. See, India-Nepal relationship is good not only for Nepal but for Indian people as well, because when in 2015 there was a blockade in Nepal, then Indian border towns was also affected, and it was the efforts of these Indian traders in these border towns that the blockade needs to be settled down. Fine. They had to brought out their own efforts. So India needs to realize the new reality, that is that its monopoly over geopolitics is Nepal is over, and there is another relationship that Nepal is nurturing. I told you earlier, this article is written from the perspective of a Nepalese. It's not from the perspective of an Indian. Otherwise, these lines would not have been written, because they are saying that India needs to realize that it's the high time and it cannot assert its monopoly over Nepal. Fine, because Nepal is now nurturing a relationship with China as well. Okay, but then the article is saying, so we have read these lines. Now it's time for India to be proactive and redefine its engagement rather than continue to be reactive. And recently, eminent persons group meetings has held, and we are hoping for the good, and we are hoping for a healthy relationship between India and Nepal. And India needs to continue to understand that there is another opportunity to rewrite bilateral and geopolitical history. And India, the writer is saying that India should understand this thing, that there is always another opportunity for you. Even if the relationship deteriorated after 2015 blockade, but there can be another chance, there can be another opportunity which India can utilize. And this time India should not be reactive, rather proactive and visionary in its approach with respect to Nepal and the kind of relationship Nepal is nurturing with China. So this was the whole idea of this article with respect to India-Nepal relationship. Thank you.